he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily...
Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack.
A loss of 9 on the play. Brings up 3rd down.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his 3rd down play as we play 3 quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The offense on 3rd down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Devin Bush, the linebacker, was the one there in pass coverage.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. Fielded at the 33. That'll go as a 42-yard punt, but a net of 32. They had a 10-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When you go to the backup, let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We, you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more.
No gain on the
absolutely play. Love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
On 3rd down, they have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is 3rd down and 12. Operating from the gun. Herbert. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or 2 shy of the 40. A good pickup, 17 yards and a Bear first down. I don't want to make a story where there's not one, but he threw the 3 interceptions last week. Looked a little uncomfortable. He looks much more comfortable today.
Yeah, just 1 pick so far in his team lead. So now they can play complimentary football, meaning if he takes care of the ball and his offense, you know, if they're humming along, the defense doesn't have to be out there as long. He's taking care of his guys on the other side of the ball.
And they're enjoying a 4th quarter advantage. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's 2nd down.
At the 43-yard line.
Here's Harris. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. They lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, they went back to him, but the results were similar, so I highly doubt that he'll get another opportunity here on 3rd and long.
So 1st and 2nd down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on 3rd and 13. From the gun, Herbert. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And that will come the offense as they take over.
22-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Now a dump off here complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Escaping the pressure right. They'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track and it cost him.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. His pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Well, partner, I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
And they'll indeed take a knee. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. So this
this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Bears, they did what they needed to do. They split their first two road games of the year, and they'll get